Hey there, this is Heather with TubeLooms.com, and in this Lightroom tutorial, I am going to be demonstrating the differences between the clone and the heal tool in Lightroom. So if you don't know much about these tools, then this video is going to be very helpful for you. So we're going to come over here to this tool. It's called the Spot Removal Tool, and when you click on it, you can either click on it or you can use the short key Q to open it. And you're going to see this menu come up. So you're going to see clone and you're going to see heal. So many people, when they're starting out with Lightroom, or even if they've been using it a while, it can be kind of confusing as to what the differences are between the clone and the heal tool. So I'm going to just show you really quickly what the differences are and how you can use them in your photo editing. So let's start with the clone tool. Make sure that it's highlighted. And when you come over here, you can adjust the size of the brush. You can also do this on your mouse scroller, which I'm doing right now. And you can also set the opacity. So if you don't want something to copy completely, then you can adjust the opacity. So I always usually have it at 100%, and then I can adjust it later if need be. So basically, the clone tool is what it says. It clones a part of the image that you select to have cloned. So it's a straight copy of pixels. So if I want to get rid of this patch of grass that was in this growing in this crack in the pavement, I can come over here, choose my brush, and wherever I select is going to straight up copy. So if I come over here, I'm going to have this straight up copy of this brush. Now if I were to choose the heal tool, you see how it's different? The heal tool actually pulls in the texture of, you know, the area that you're choosing, but it adjusts the color to match the surrounding areas. So I'm going to go back to clone, and I'm going to move this over here. Now I'm just going to press done, and you can see how there's this, you know, edging around the brush where I had it selected. This can be a problem in Lightroom because depending on your photo, you can have all these little brush marks and whatnot because of the clone tool. So I'm going to go back here and I'm going to right click delete. Now the heal tool is really cool because you can come over here and essentially do the same thing, but it's going to adjust the color and pull in the texture of this area right here, but it's going to adjust the color to the surrounding area. So let me click done, and it's not as definitive of a circle mark as it was before. And you can adjust your brush size to make it bigger or smaller, whatnot, and it's, you know, it's not going to be as visible. So I'm going to just kind of go over here, just kind of fill this in. And most of the time when I am working with, you know, wanting to take something out of a photo, I usually turn to the heal brush because, like I showed you before, it pulls in the texture, but it adjusts the color. So it's a nice, it's a more smooth transition, and it's not as noticeable. So I'm just going to push done. So basically, you know, this could take a while for me to go through and to really polish it up. And I did actually do this one earlier really quickly. It could use a little touching up, but you can see how, let me show you, well, you can see how the light in the image still stayed the same because I used the clone or the healing brush, but it pulled in the texture of their surrounding areas. So I can come over here and show you all my little brush strokes that I applied. So that's basically it. I also did a little bit on his leg because he had some little scrapes and whatnot. So let me show you how I did that. I'm going to just zoom in really quick. if it'll let me. Here we go. And my computer is thinking. Okay. So I'm going to change the size of my brush. I'm using the scroller on my mouse. And I'm on the heel tool. And I'm just going to make a selection. Oops. Come on, computer. It's thinking for a second. Okay. So then I can, you know, pull this little circle anywhere, and it's going to adjust the texture and the color. Okay. So I can just continue to do that all around his leg and remove all of those blemishes. And again, since my computer is decided to run a little bit slower than normal, I'm just going to click done. See how it's very even blended and whatnot. So really give the spot removal brush or the spot removal tool some practice and see which one you like better. Like I said, I use the healing brush a lot more because it blends in more nicely. The cloning tool does have its purposes for different photos. But anyways, I hope this cleared up any kind of confusion you had about this tool and about the clone and the healing brush. So if you found this tutorial useful, I would really appreciate a like on this video, a thumbs up if you would. And make sure you subscribe to my channel if you found this tutorial useful for updated Lightroom tutorials. So thanks for tuning in, and I will see you next time. Bye.